What's up, world? What's up, YouTube? This is your girl Jade Cole here, recapping on America's Next Top Model Cycle 17 All-Stars, episode number 5. Now, it took 5 weeks for them to give us an episode worth watching. Starting off, they show some of the girls in their vehicle of transportation while playing clips and seeing subtitles and hearing ad libs of Brie saying that she thought working as a model for the last 6 years, she assumed she would be a front runner in this competition. But Brie, did you not read the contract either? I mean, girl, it doesn't matter if you are a real model. Heck, I mean, before I even entered into this unrealistic competition, I too was a working model living in New York City at the time.
Understand nothing was done for me, so I don't plan on stopping at all.
And look how they downplayed my image on the show.
Jade, I'm so gorgeous. I'm so gorgeous.
But
I'm
you
so
know
perfect.
What?
Jade is a bit tranny for me, and that's why I love her.
I wonder why she feels the need to constantly say how amazing she is. Not only trying to convince others, but you're trying to convince yourself.
I think if conceited drag queen is in, then perhaps she has a future in modeling.
Jade, you march to your own drum. But if you knew everything, Jade, you'd be a supermodel already, and that hasn't happened yet.
What's with the head wrap?
It's just the Jade style.
You look like an arrogant bitch to me.
I'm sorry?
Jade, I want you to soften it up just a little bit.
Sorry.
Because it's coming off a little hard.
It's actually kind of difficult when you're working with a girl who thinks she's a model already.
But again, it's just a TV reality show, which gives a false sense of what we know to be real reality. But also, it has such a psychological and sociological impact on the public as well as the participants. And this has definitely been highly controversial. Next, as they also highlight Lisa, showing recap clips of her while also hearing ad libs of her talking about being in the bottom two and how ultimately the girls think she's going home and that she feels that being on ANTM All Stars is a platform where she can brand herself on a much higher level and that this is an opportunity she will not let go. So, Lisa, I mean, why would you actually think they would give you a fair chance in showing your true self? Duh. Next, they show some of the girls arriving in the house while focusing on a very happy Anjali as you see her serenading Joy as she sees her picture up on the wall for best pick of the week while they play ad-libs of her also saying, "When I was on TV, I was hot, but then no major agencies wanted to sign me after the show." Now, isn't that interesting? It must be because America's Next Top Model is not taken seriously in the real world of modeling, as it is just looked at as a mockery. But instead, Tyra should really show the audience how it really is portrayed in the modeling industry. Hence my point that this is not a real modeling competition, but only a recycled ball of a drowning reality show that desperately needs a change. As it appears to have a lot of y'all fooled into believing what good old Miss Tyra Banks is telling you, as she repeatedly tends to pollute people's minds with such a distorted version of reality.
Just take my time. I don't even need it. Because I don't like getting yelled at. I have a sensitive spirit.
So now the crying Christian is going off and I'm standing there like this. I didn't do it. It wasn't me. I didn't do anything to you. I didn't touch you. I didn't yell at you.
But what actually really happened between Bianca and Shannon, as it doesn't appear like Bianca is yelling or being hostile with her, right? But I guess to the audience, all we see is Shannon ready to fall apart.
I'm willing to give up my time. I don't need it. I don't like to argue. I don't like confrontation.
Bianca is just standing there like, what just happened? Just like how they did to me. Check it out.
You have got it so twisted.
I don't have it twisted,
sweetheart. You do. I really didn't appreciate dinner. I thought that was so uncalled for.
Oh, Jade, I don't want
to. Well, we're gonna have to do this now because I really.
Jade, I don't want to talk about.
Well, we're gonna. Why not?
Are you really shocked that I called you out? I mean,
I'm very shocked. I'm sitting here trying to make peace.
So now, do you all get it? I mean, so getting back. Clearly, it's evident that Lisa and Bianca got into a little debate about the phone situation as Shannon was just crying wolf. When they show the girls at the Santa Monica Pier while Miss J is waiting there for them, Bree said it right. Who dressed Miss J today is the question. I mean, doesn't this guy get paid like $45,000 an episode? And if so, why does he always look and appear as if he is homeless?
Clothing and making it come alive a bit.
He then proceeds to tell the girls that this is the perfect setting for an all-star fashion show and that their challenge for the day will be stepping off of a moving runway carousel.
You'll be stepping on and off of a moving carousel.
While also modeling clothes designed by the Kardashians. Then after they show the Kardashian sisters coming in to surprise the girls and give them some words of encouragement. And Khloé adds by saying that the lucky winner will get to take home a head-to-toe outfit from their collection. But wait, guys, that's it? I mean, I adore the Kardashians and all, but again, this is supposed to be the all-stars, right? I mean, how about a shopping spree with the Kardashian girls? Or how about a luncheon with Kim? I mean, I feel like this would be much more of a suitable prize for this challenge, don't you think? Later, Brie and Lisa won the challenge. Then after, they showed the girls backstage with Miss J, and he asked Bianca, why is she mad? But you guys, how can anyone take Miss J seriously? But again, in this scene, it is so cut up as Bianca expresses her upsetment to Miss J. But the drama doesn't stop there, as it appears that Bianca and Lisa have some underlining issues. And as they return back to their home, they show a distressed Bianca on the phone crying, meanwhile showing most of the girls downstairs in the kitchen conspiring about how Bianca needs to leave, so they will all have less competition, as Bree said it correct. Now on to the photo shoot. There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. Now, I have always been such a huge fan of Michael Jackson. Even as a little kid, I loved watching Michael, as he was so captivating and intriguing to me. He is the greatest performer of all time. And it was so cool to see that for this photo shoot, the girls will be portraying Michael Jackson through his years, while also being styled by MJ's personal assistant, Rushka, and also having a surprise guest appearance by his sister, LaToya Jackson, who will be there watching the girls as they shoot. Now, from what you guys have seen during the photo shoot clips of each girl shooting, who do you think is bad? That's right, who's bad? Now on to the eliminations.
This evening, Top Model did something that we have never done before. We had our guest judge decide who was best photo.
And I just love the part where LaToya talks about Michael Jackson and she says,
to tell you that my brother was about love, expression, about giving. What I saw in the photo shoot is that you girls all gave.
How touching was that? We miss you, Michael, and thank you all so much for watching, as I have truly valued and cherished every moment in time with all of you. Episode 5 will be my last recap of the ANTM All-Stars, and I so appreciate this love and honor of recognition. And by you all taking the time out and listening to my thoughts and my opinions about the show, as I will now be transitioning into my own show. Look out, look forward, and definitely stay tuned. Happy Halloween, everyone.
I'll take you home.